Welcome back to another episode of Hey Fam with Dr. Sam I Am, featuring Dr. Sabrine Mudawali, bringing you the best in educational tips to help you and your students thrive.
Hey fam, Dr. Sam I Am here, back to you again with another video. Before we get started, please make sure that you guys like, make sure you share, make sure you also subscribe below, and as well as slide the notification over to the right, and so that you can get notifications when I post a brand new video. So we're back again today with another edition for the 911 help, Dr. Sam I Am, for my parents. So you call and I come running. So today we're going to discuss the difference between remote learning and virtual learning. So here it goes. I had a lot of questions from parents like, Dr. Sam, like, which one should I do? Should I do remote learning? Should I do virtual learning? And I tell parents, it is up to you. What is the best for learning style for your child? So here's the difference between remote learning and virtual learning. Remote learning is temporary, okay? You will have several live classes and pre-recorded classes for your child. With the remote learning, again, it is temporary. There's only a set amount of time that we will be remote learning. So some parents have asked, Dr. Sam I Am, but what happened when we first got into the pandemic? I mean, it was just so disorganized. There was so many things out there. We didn't know, you know, when my child was supposed to log on and different things like that. To be honest with you guys, most teachers, most districts at the time was in emergency mode. We were not prepared for a pandemic. None of us have ever experienced this. And so what the difference is going to be this time is that we have prepared for this season of remote learning. Teachers have been going through professional development all summer. You have various districts that have bought different platforms such as Google Suites. Those districts who use Canvas have now purchased also Nearpod. And so there's so many more resources and tools that are being handed down to teachers, that teachers are being trained in order to better educate your child during this remote season. And so with the remote learning, again, you will eventually return back into the classroom. Whereas virtual learning is actually more permanent. Many districts have now began a virtual academy where your child can actually go virtually for the entire school year. Some parents may say, well, Dr. Sam, I want my child to go virtually for the first semester, probably for the first couple of months. I don't know. Can I change back? Well, with the virtual academy, you gotta be careful, because if you decide later on that you want your child to return into the classroom, the child has to spend at least one semester in the virtual academy before they return. But again, the virtual academy is an option that you have. You do have to apply to virtual academy, whereas with remote learning, you do not have to apply. You automatically are going to be taken into the remote learning model because that's where the district is currently. However, with virtual learning, you do have to apply for the virtual learning academy. And so when we come back, you guys know I got my handy dandy notes, so make sure I give you guys accurate information. Most of your lessons when it comes to virtual academy is going to be pre-recorded lessons, and you get to choose when learning actually takes place. So if you know your child best learns in the morning, if they best learn in the afternoon or in the evening, you choose when the learning schedule and when learning will take place for your child. And so again, one of the things you have to remember when it comes to virtual and remote learning is that discipline is a big thing, especially with the virtual learning, because remember, there is no actual live teacher that's going to go there, though there are teachers, and virtual academies actually do have principals or supervisors. There are teachers and so forth and so on. You don't have the flexibility as you would with the remote learning. Again, accountability and responsibility is another big thing when it comes to virtual learning. Okay, you have to be held accountable for the learning needs of your child, as well as you're responsible for the learning needs of your child. So if you design that your child is going to go to school 8 a.m. to 12 noon virtually because they're enrolled in a virtual academy, I will highly suggest that you stick to the schedule. So here goes my 5 tips on deciding whether you want to do remote learning or virtual learning. Again, it is up to you guys. Either way, you can't go wrong either way. But again, it is really up to you guys. So if you're weighing your options, here are 5 tips to help you make a decision. Tip number one, watch the board meeting and read all the notes. The notes. Did you guys hear that stutter and that mispronunciation? Oh, sorry. So make sure you guys read the notes. Watch the board meeting. Many districts, their board meetings have now been virtual, of course. And you can always watch those meetings online or on the school's website. Many of those meetings are pre-recorded, not pre-recorded, excuse me, recorded live and later posted. And so once the meeting is recorded, you can go back, watch the meeting, make sure that you read the board notes so that you have a plethora of information that you can make an educated decision. Talk to your child's teachers, okay, or the child's administrator. You know, a lot of times we make decisions and we don't take in consideration some very important individuals, not just the child, but also the child's teacher. So you want to talk to the child's teacher and see what are the resources and options are out there so that, again, you can have the information to make an educated decision. Tip number three, consult with others. Talk to other parents, okay? Talk to other individuals who are member of the school community, whether it is the PTA or whether, again, it's the child's teacher, administrators. If you know someone who works in the school system, consult other individuals as you are pending and making that decision whether you want your child to go remote or virtually. Tip number four, talk with your spouse or your significant other. Also, if you are a single parent, I'll definitely say consult whether it is your mom, your father, another family member, some other individuals who know the child and who has a great idea as to what will be in the best interest of the child. But one of the things I also want to encourage parents, please include the child in the discussion. Many a times we're having discussions around the child and we fail to include the child. Now, this has to be age appropriate. If your child's a kindergartner, yes, we can talk to the child about it, but when it comes to making a final decision, of course, that is on you, the parent. But if you have a high schooler, include that child in the conversation. You know, they know what's best when it comes also the way they learn, their learning style, okay? So if they are not disciplined enough or if they have issues with when it comes to structuring as far as remote learning or even virtual learning is considered, include that child because they'll know, because they'll have to be the one sitting in front of that computer and learning. And the last tip, you know what I would say, pray about it. Take it to God. You know, definitely pray and seek God's face as to what it is that you need to do as far as your child's education. So again, those are my five tips. Watch that board meeting, read all the notes. Tip number two, talk to your child's teacher, administrator. Tip number three, consult others, whether it be different parents, whether it be someone else who works in the school system. Tip number four, speak with your spouse or your significant other and include your child in that conversation. If you are a single parent, speak to somebody else in your family who knows that child as well as you know that child. And tip number five, just pray about it. All right. And I hope this helps someone know the difference between remote learning, virtual learning, and those who are weighing their options. Now that you have this information, I pray that you make an educated decision. What is in the best interest of your child? Nobody knows your child better than you. So before we go, of course, you guys know I got to leave you with an education quote. And today's quote is coming from the late, great Malcolm X. And Malcolm X said, "Education is the passport to the future, for tomorrow belongs to those who prepare for it today." Again, thank you guys so much for watching my video. I hope you guys got something out of this today. Make sure you stay tuned next week when you yell, "Help, Dr. Sam, here I come running." I love you guys. Have a great day.